Mr. and Mrs. North, starring Barbara Britton and Richard Denning.
This is the right room, but it's the wrong car.
You sure this isn't our room?
Yes, darling, I'm sure. Look, here are the tickets. See? Wrong car. Now, come on, let's get started. I want to get settled before this trip is over.
French fashion expert says skirts are to be shorter this year. I like that. This cat burglar nabbed. A special building patrol officer is credited with the pre-dawn capture of a thief who had broken into the office of Collier J. Brown, Undersecretary of Defense.
Pam.
What is it?
I love you, darling, but it happens that I'm trying to work, and it's impossible when you're reading aloud. Do I make myself clear?
Yes, Jerry. But.
But what?
Well, I thought maybe you were tired of your work. After all, we spent the whole weekend in Washington with the senator's memories, and frankly, Jerry...
Frankly, Pam, I have a publication date to meet.
wife is hungry and the dining car is open. Do these facts suggest anything to you?
Oh, of course. Why don't you get some dinner, darling? And bring me back a ham on rye and some coffee, hmm?
I know you're going to miss me terribly. Bye.
How do you spell agrarianism, Pam?
Naturally, you're so attractive, I'm sure you don't have that problem. Thanks.
I'm very sorry.
Oh, isn't that clumsy of me? The car lurched. It's all my fault.
I'm terribly sorry. That was awfully clumsy of my friend.
I lost my balance.
You must be sure to let me pay the cleaning bill, of course. Maybe even buy you a new dress.
I'll take that bag.
This is yours, madam. I'm very sorry.
Business if you like, but you're in some sort of trouble, aren't you?
Trouble? Why, no.
Well, are men always throwing food into your lap so they'll have an opportunity of going through your handbag? Because that's what that act was about that those two just put on in the dining car. Well,
I'm sure you must be mistaken. But it's kind of you to be so concerned about me.
Suit yourself. But don't be in a rush to see what it was that he took out of your bag, because I got it away from him before he had a chance to get anything.
Thank you. Can I get this door for you?
Do you feel all right? What is it?
I do feel a little faint. Have you got a handkerchief? Weak, but I'll be all right.
Of course you will.
Anything wrong, ladies?
I felt as though I were going to faint, but I'm fine now.
Let me help you to your compartments.
Thank you.
There you are, miss.
Thank you. I'm feeling better already.
I'll be glad to stay with you if you like.
I think I would like that.
All right, I'll be back as soon as I take Jerry a sandwich.
If you need anything at all, just ring for the porter.
And keep that poor girl company. Well, that is, if you don't mind.
Mind? No, not at all. Right now, I'm traveling through Outer Mongolia with the senator. There's no country for women.
That's good. See you later, Jerry. Mm. Hello, I'm... Oh, I'm sorry. I must be in the wrong... No, I'm not. What happened to the girl who had this compartment?
Girl? Did you have a girl in here?
Well, how long have you been in here?
Why, since we left Washington. Obviously, you've made a mistake. Are you sure this is the right car?
Yes, I'm sure it isn't. This is her compartment, too.
The gentlemen are correct. They've occupied that compartment throughout the trip. Now, if you'll excuse me,
Now, just a minute. You mean to tell me you don't remember not 10 minutes ago in this very vestibule?
I've just been telling you I don't recall any fainting girl. I don't remember helping you with anyone, sick or well, male or female, into that compartment.
Will you please tell me something? How is it you can always manage to come up with some deep-dyed, mysterious problem, no matter where we happen to be?
How do I know? You make me sound like Typhoid Mary or something.
Typhoid Mary? You know, she probably wasn't a bad sort at all. If I'd met her while I was still a bachelor...
Look, are you going to sit here brooding over your lost opportunities, or are you coming with me?
Coming, beloved.
Good. I'm going to prove to you I'm not making this whole thing up.
Someone's...
Excuse me.
What?
Oh, hello there. Have you found your friend?
No, I haven't. Oh. Would you mind telling me one thing?
Certainly, whatever you like.
Do you remember seeing me in the dining car?
Oh, what a question, of course. I'm a little nearsighted, but such a pretty girl.
Thank you. Do you remember when you bumped into the waiter and you dropped the tray on the table?
I remember that. How could I forget my clumsiness? That was unforgivable.
Well, then you must remember the girl who was at my table.
No, wait. No, there was no woman with you. No, you were entirely alone. Yes?
Well, what are you so happy about?
I just saw that North woman. She's trying to convince her husband she's not been seeing things and she's ready for a straitjacket.
Oh, come in.
May I speak to you a minute?
Oh, what's troubling you?
That North woman in the next car.
Oh, what's the matter?
She can make an awful fuss. I've been wondering if it wouldn't be wise to tell her about the girl.
No, the Secret Service doesn't operate that way.
We've captured a foreign agent on the train tonight. But we're not going to broadcast that fact by telling every feather-brained housewife is interested.
You briefed the waiter, didn't you, what he was to tell her?
I just don't want any trouble, that's all.
There won't be any trouble. That Secret Service can't handle.
How do you like me as a Secret Service agent?
Wonderful performance. I was impressed.
I didn't hear.
Now, look, sweetheart, you're all right. There has to be some perfectly logical explanation for that girl's disappearance.
Well, what? What could it be?
Well, perhaps it could be that maybe she had you and the conductor take her to the wrong compartment.
Why?
Well, I don't know why. Let's just say for reasons of her own. And then she tipped the conductor handsomely and asked him to forget the whole thing.
That's not bad.
Nah.
Not bad at all. What about the waiter and the rest of the passengers? Did you tip them handsomely, too? I doubt it.
Yeah, but it is possible, isn't it?
Yes, but not very probable. At any rate, why would she do it?
Well, does it matter why?
It all reminds me of something. I can't put my finger on it, but it's something.
Look, I'm reminded of something, too.
You are?
Yes, I'm reminded that if I don't get my nose back to that grindstone, I'll never meet that publication date. Here, now sit down and find a crossword puzzle. Maybe you'll have better luck with that. What is it?
Out there. That was a coffin.
So?
I'll bet anything that she's inside of it.
Ooh. Oh, no.
Why not?
Because they're taking it up to load on the baggage car, not taking it off. Want any other reasons?
Thank you.
Well, maybe I can get some work done. Did they miss us?
They didn't say.
Cold as a fish. I believe that's the expression. Oh, now look, sweetheart. I waited at the train gate patiently with you until even the porters had gone home. Now, can't you accept things the way... Come in. Pam, you remember these gentlemen from the train? This is Dr. David Ennis of the United States Public Health Service and his assistant, Dr. Huntley.
Yes. How do you do?
They've come to see us about your disappearing friend.
How do you do? Public Health Service? Doctors? Oh, wait a minute. Now I know what I've been trying to remember. The Paris Exposition.
What on earth?
I think I understand. Yes, I too remember the legend of the vanishing lady at the Paris Exposition.
Well, that's the story I've been trying to remember.
You do understand now.
You mean that girl on the train had the bubonic plague?
Oh, no. Yes. We were fortunate to catch it at a very early stage and to isolate it before everyone on the train was exposed.
Oh, my goodness.
This young lady is now in a hospital, and her chances for recovery are really quite good. Mrs. North, there's no reason for you to be alarmed, despite the fact that you were the only person on the train directly exposed. A nurse will be here within the hour with proper inoculations. You have nothing to fear.
That's a relief.
I want you both to go into the bedroom and undress.
Undress?
I must have everything you had with you on the train tonight. Everything.
It's really quite simple. We'll have all your things decontaminated and returned to you intact by tomorrow morning at the latest.
I see. Is all this really necessary?
It's a routine precaution, but a very important one.
I would say the sooner the better, Mr. North.
Yeah, well, in that case, if you'll just make yourselves comfortable. Come on, darling.
Thank you. I don't like to hurry, Mrs. North, but...
Oh, sure. I'll see what I can do.
Thank you.
Are your things ready, Pam?
Jerry, there's something I want...
Later, darling. They're waiting, and the sooner they take this stuff, the sooner we'll get it back.
But I'm not
sure... This is everything, isn't it?
But Jerry... will you please give me the telephone number of the United States Public Health Service?
Now, you will be careful with that manuscript, won't you?
We'll get it back to you in tip-top shape, Mr. North.
Okay.
Good night, and thanks for your cooperation.
Thank you.
Good night.
Night. The first chance I've had to relax all day. Am I ready to fall apart?
Well, pull yourself together. Those doctors were fakers. I mean, those fakers weren't doctors.
What?
Oh, what I'm trying to say is they're not from the public health department. I just checked.
But who? What? Well, what were they looking for? What did they want?
This. I found it in my handbag.
Well, that's the last place I'd expect to find a lipstick.
Oh, I'm serious, Jerry. Take the lid off. There's microfilm in it.
Microfilm.
That's what those two fakers were after. Unless you want to believe this is something new in old clothes drives.
Yeah, but how did you get this?
That girl on the train. She must have dropped it into my handbag. At least those two men think she did. Oh, Jerry, that girl was on the train. Do you suppose they could have killed her?
I don't know, but I think we ought to find out.
What are you going to do?
Let's call Bill Wagon. Lieutenant Wagon, please. Jerry North calling.
I'll go get dressed.
No, stick around a minute. Bill, listen, can you meet us at Penn Station? No. Now, I want you to check compartment number...
Compartment number 7, car 1074, Capital Clipper.
You got that? Yeah, that's right. Look, Pam thinks the girl who occupied that compartment may have been murdered. No, I think she's right this time. Look, Bill, we'll meet you there and tell you the whole story, okay? Right.
Apartment 7, car 1074, the Capital Clipper.
This is it. All right, check that.
Give me the pass key.
Deader than yesterday's newspaper, all right. How Pam North does it, I'll never know. Look, you take over the fort and don't touch anything. I've got to get to the nearest phone.
I'll probably never see those galley proofs again. And after all that work...
Well, forget about your old galley proofs. The important thing is...
Bet you don't make any noise, Mrs. North. Inside, quickly. Get over there. Mrs. North. You too, North. I'll make it brief, Mrs. North. One woman has already died because she wouldn't produce that roll of microfilm we want. You understand?
Yes.
Good. Then give me the film.
I don't have it.
You're wasting my time, Mrs. North. We know you were the only person on that train Andrea contacted. You're too foolish to be a spy. And we didn't find the film among your effects. So you must have it. Get over there, away from your husband. Stand still, Mr. North, or I'll kill your wife. Eric, the purse. Watch him. Nothing. To persuade you to speak, Mrs. North, and I'm very persuasive.
Don't touch her.
If you move again, Mr. North, Eric will shoot you. Essentially, I'm not a barbaric man, Mrs. North, but that roll of film means a great deal to my government, so we'll just see what price you and your husband put upon your government secrets.
With your friend, Dennis.
Jerry, you were wonderful.
Oh, it's nothing, darling. Nothing any red-blooded American boy couldn't do.
Jerry. Jerry, can't we put the senator to bed for tonight?
Good night, my red-blooded American boy.
Say something?
Goodbye, Ralph Francis Murphy. A John W. Loveton production. Produced by Federal Telefilms. Starring Barbara Britton and Richard Denning, featuring Francis DeSales. Film presentation.